I'm thoroughly enjoying it. I mean, it's been I can't say it's been a massive adaptation, because it's the life I come from. But I mean, it's good to feel back home and being back in that home environment. I think it's a fairly similar style of patterns of play with obviously under Carlos Spencer, you know. Environmental-wise, it's been great being part of obviously part of the King setup, working towards something. Luke has built a great system, put a great system in place for the boys to feel comfortable. He's really put like priority on me to kind of just get the ball out quick out of the rucks, right there, perfect passes, perfect spirals, and I must be quick on my feet. And he's just told me, listen, when you go on the park, show intent to be ambiguous and just play your natural game.
You know, that famous under the leg pass,
yeah,
live in the corner against the box. The ball handling skills has been phenomenal. He's helped me with delivering and receiving the ball and just delivering a quick pass without any arm movements, just from the wrist, from the flick of the wrist, and just basic spatial awareness.
He definitely has. I mean, this is the third game on the trot now. He spoke to me, told me, listen, your chance will come, just continue playing. He sat me down after the Bulls game. He told me, listen, yeah, just continue playing, you know, doing what you do well, and just continue focusing on the basics that I told you to focus on from the very beginning. I'm actually looking forward to that. I mean, the first game, the opening game of the Curry Cup, I was definitely looking forward to that. You know, I always told him, listen, yeah, to ensure that his A and B pillars are always away, because I'm going to catch them. He just said, don't worry, we have the best defense. Now, obviously, as a youngster, I went to his house a lot. I stayed with him for a year. When we were still in PE and my parents moved to his London, I stayed with him for a year. So it was always great to go with him to training, go with him to school. I kind of followed him. You know, he was my mentor. And obviously, seeing him thrive in the rugby, in the rugby world, you know, I kept on watching him grow. When we were Springbok coach, I was always behind the scenes, got excited when he was on TV, you know, and I just felt myself, listen, I want to be there, you know. And I obviously, as I grew up, I just also achieved a few things in my rugby career. And I just asked him, listen, what is a basic step that I can take in order to achieving, you know, what you've achieved and beyond. Just tell him, listen, just go out and enjoy it, you know, have fun, do what you need to do, do the basics, but just go out and have fun.
No, they support the up and coming, and they support me, so that's good to have their backs and so forth. My granny is, Alistair's mom actually said, after the Lions game, I think it was, she didn't know I was actually that good, which I was actually just... I would love to be one of the first Springboks that's being selected from the Rugby Kings. Obviously, that's a goal that I've wanted from a very young age, and just to represent the Kings on the highest possible level. Thank you.